Okay. Reading Rainbow, episode 70. Sunken treasure. It is 1622. The Atosha, with its fleet of sister ships, makes its way back from South America to Spain. The Atosha is a treasure ship laden with gold, jewels, silver bars, and thousands of coins. The fleet makes a stop in Cuba, and then sets off again. As the ships near Florida, a hurricane gathers strength. Wind rips at the Atosha's sails, spray washes across the deck. The 265 people aboard the ship are terrified. Suddenly, a huge wave lifts the ship and throws it against the reef. The hull breaks open, and the Atosha, along with several of its sister ships, sinks beneath the waves. All but five aboard the Atosha drown. Spain wants its treasure back. Search ships are sent out. They find one of the Atosha's sister ships, the Santa Margarita, and salvage begins. Sponge and Pearl divers bring some of the Santa Margarita's treasure to the surface, but the Atosha cannot be found. Hundreds of years go by. The Atosha is almost forgotten. Storms and strong sea currents scatter its treasure for miles along the ocean floor. The ship slowly rots and breaks into pieces. Sand covers the remains. In the early 1960s, a new search begins. A man named Mel Fisher has read about the Atosha. He is determined to find the lost treasure ship. He will need boats, crew, and equipment. Investors provide the money, and the venture gets underway. Search boats go to where it is believed the Atosha went down. The boats are fitted with modern equipment for exploring the ocean bottom. When the instruments register a hit, divers go down to investigate. They keep in view of each other and regularly check their air supplies. Large elbow-shaped pipes called mailboxes are swung into place. The mailboxes are Mel Fisher's invention. The whirling of the boat's propellers forces water through the mailboxes, blowing large holes in the sand. If anything is buried, it will be uncovered. But only litter is found, nothing of value, nothing from the Atosha. Where should they look next? Mel Fisher asks for help from Eugene Lyon, an expert who can translate old Spanish documents. Lyon looks through stacks of shipping records from the 1600s. The work takes years. Finally, in 1970, he finds a clue. He discovers new evidence pointing to where the Atosha sank, a new area 100 miles away from where the team has been looking. Lyon also finds a cargo list that tells where the Atosha was carrying. A search boat moves to the new location. In 1971, a huge gallant anchor, several muskets, and gold bars and chains are found. But are they from the Atosha? There is no way to prove it. 2 years later, three heavy silver bars are recovered. The bars with their markings match up with the Atosha's cargo list. Now they have proof. Then, in 1975, the Atosha's bronze cannons are found. The crew believe they are getting closer to the mother lode, the main treasure of the ship. But they are wrong. Day after day, they search the huge area. Many more years go by. Crew members leave and new ones sign on. When the money runs out, new investors must be found. In 1985, the crew go back and search a site they had searched years ago. And then it happens. A big hit registers on their equipment. Divers go down.
We found it! The motherlode!
Mel Fisher's 20-year search is finally over, resting on the ocean floor. 55 feet below is the Atosha's fabled treasure, gleaming gold bars, jewelry, gold and silver coins, and other precious finds. Nearly all the listed cargo is there, and more. Some treasure must have been smuggled aboard. The crew works with a marine archaeologist, Duncan Mathewson. He insists that the motherlode not be disturbed. A grid of plastic pipes is laid over the site. The divers take pictures and make drawings square by square. Each square of the grid is numbered. That way, the exact position of each timber, coin, and artifact is recorded. Later, archaeologists and historians will use this information to learn about times past. Now the treasure can be brought to the surface. Salvage boats are moved in. Divers descend and crew members lower baskets over the side to them. The divers gently fan the sand with their hands and use an airlift to carefully suck it away. As treasure is recovered, other artifacts are exposed underneath. Each piece of treasure must be accounted for. Again, everything found is sketched and photographed. One after another, baskets full of treasure are raised to the surface. Each day, the work continues, dive after dive. Dive after dive after dive. More treasure is recovered from the deep. It is hard work and can be done only in good weather. The salvage goes on for weeks, months, and years. Silver bars... Oh, wait. In a building back on the mainland, other workers sort the treasure as it is brought in from the salvage site. Some of the treasure will crumble if it is exposed to air. Soaking it in water preserves it temporarily. Later, workers will determine the right way to preserve each artifact permanently. Silver coins are put into chemical baths to clean and restore them. In 1 or 2 days, they will look like new. Silver bars soak in chemical baths too, but they will take longer to clean. They are bigger. The gold from the Atosha is already shiny. Gold never loses its luster. There were many pottery storage jars on board the Atosha. Amazingly, some were recovered whole. Other jars had been shattered and now must be pieced together again. Cataloging of the Atosha's treasure is done in several ways. A photographer takes pictures of a sword. Coins are scanned by a computer, and an exact description of each one is stored in the computer's memory. An artist draws pictures of a gold plate and an emerald-studded necklace. This kind of careful cataloging provides a valuable record for the future. Some of the treasure will go to museums. Some will go to the investors, and some will go to the crew. All of them made it possible for Mel Fisher's long search to continue. A computer works out what each one's fair share will be. The treasure of Nuestra Señora de Atosha is valued at hundreds of millions of dollars. A very wealthy treasure ship indeed. The wreck and its artifacts will be studied by historians and archaeologists for years to come. Their discoveries will enrich our knowledge of the past. This will be the second treasure of the Atosha. The end.